Caught on tape, a police officer beating a handcuffed prisoner. Tonight, that officer is off the job, convicted in the beating, and then trying to cover it up. As Action News reporter Marcy Cipriani tells us tonight, the Avalon police officer will now spend time behind bars.
Former Avalon police officer Walter Johnson was convicted, prosecutors say mainly because of this surveillance video captured inside the holding cell that's been described as brutal. This is the video from inside cell number 2. Watch as then Avalon officer Walter Johnson escorts a handcuffed man to the door, then throws him more than 10 feet into the wall. Robert Zalagi lies there for some time. Then, once he sits up, it becomes clear just how badly he was hurt as blood pools on the cell floor.
There were not just lacerations, there were broken bones around his face.
District Attorney Steven Zappala says it was this video that proved their case. During the time Zalagi was in the holding cell and injured, Officer Johnson can be seen taking his picture with a camera phone, talking or yelling to him, and prosecutors say simply not caring.
I have the greatest respect for the law enforcement community, and overwhelmingly the ladies and gentlemen who do this work are good people. That's just not, that's not acceptable.
Zalagi was brought here after Avalon police arrested him for being drunk and in a fight along Cleveland Avenue. There were claims some of the injuries were from that.
Without that camera, you have a one-on-one, you know, very different type of story.
Although it's unclear what happened in the moments before this video was captured, the DA says nothing excuses this.
Most of the time, you're going to, you know, you're going to see that the actions of the police are proper, and they act in accordance with their training. Right? On the other hand, if you have a police officer that shouldn't be in uniform, let's get rid of that person as quickly and efficiently as possible.
The former officer was placed immediately on probation, and he's scheduled to report to the Allegheny County Jail in January, where he will serve his 2-week sentence. In Avalon, Marcy Cipriani, Channel 4 Action News.